Dobrý deň pre všetkých divákov Islabs. Tu máme legendu svetovej kulturistiky a prilahlých vesmírov. Tom Platz, priamo z Kalifornie, tu v Petržalke, v Bratislave dnes 20. januára 2018. Je to neuveriteľný pocit, možno aj počujete, že sa mi chveje hlas, lebo túto legendu všetci tlé roky uznávame a sledovali sme jeho neuveriteľné výkony a na podiach a jeho životnú dráhu. Mr. Tom Platz, welcome to Slovakia. It's a pleasure to welcome you here. And with Islabs here, the most happening net portal, Generation Iron Slovak style.
I hear a lot about Islabs.
And Islabs is famous, and thanks to Igor, the founder, the amazing story, another one.
My pleasure and honor to be here.
Jem so to be s vami. Slovakia, when you hear the name Slovakia, does it ring a bell or?
I've heard Slovakia mentioned in conversation. There's a very good bodybuilder from Slovakia named Roman. I don't know Roman's last name, or I can't think of it right now, but he was in California. And I was working with him in California, in the gym, in Gold's Gym. And Roman came back to Slovakia to be with his girlfriend. And they plan on getting married. But he was a tremendous athlete. I'm like, wow. Mm-hmm. So that's when I really first noticed Slovakia. So now that our business plan is to go around the world one more time. In the 80s, I was every country in the world. Okay. Now I have the opportunity to go around the world one more time.
Amazing.
Okay, I'm 62 years old. I figure, okay, I'm still young enough. Okay, I'm still squatting hard, by the way.
I'm sure.
But I think one more time around the world to talk to every bodybuilder in every country, and then I stay home more. Okay, but we have a mission. I've been gifted. I've been fortunate, and I'm honored to have a very good life in bodybuilding. Very good mentally, spiritually, physically, financially. It's been very good to me, and I thank God for that. But now, I don't care about the money. I don't care about Tom Platz becoming famous. My job is to give back to the bodybuilder, to enable, to assist bodybuilders to realize that they can do anything they want to do in Slovakia and every other country in the world. So that's when I first thought about Slovakia, thinking, Slovakia, let's go there.
Okay. Amazing, and today is the day. Skrátka, len aby som rekapituloval, takže Tom Platz, čo pre nás znamená Slovensko, pred pár rokmi cvičil s veľmi dobrým kulturistom, s Romanom, nepamätá si jeho zvyšné meno, s ktorým mal veľmi dobré zážitky. Potom sa musel ten Roman vrátiť na Slovensko. Tom, ďakujem. Áno, Roman Vavrečan, tak je to jasné. I know the guy. Yeah, he should be somewhere around, actually. He should be here, actually. That's funny. He's a pro now.
Yeah.
He's a pro now. Yeah. So, good training. good coaching. A jeho plánom je vlastne vrátiť niečo do kulturistiky, ktorá k nemu bola veľmi prázdnivá po všetkých stránkach, niečo vrátiť a vlastne v súčasných jeho 62 rokoch chce niečo vrátiť aj tomuto športu a chce ešte raz obísť celý svet a chce toto posolstvo ďalej kázať po všetkých krajinách a toto zahrňa aj Slovensko, takže dneska to prišlo. And today is the day you can preach. You should tattoo Mr. Squat till you drop. Že by si ma vytetovať, Scott, drepujte, až kým neodpadnete. How do you feel as you get in a little bit the middle age, let's call it middle age, how do you feel the age in bodybuilding and the fitness lifestyle? How would you, because it affects me as well, and I hear a lot of, I get a lot of feedback, and I feel great, and I do big ways and everything. And how do you feel? What is your opinion about that?
I love being 62 years old. 62 years old, I feel like I'm 22. I really do. I mean, I'm every day I wake up and I look forward to training in the day and traveling to the next country. I think 60, I don't want to go back to being 22. Mm-hmm. 22 was a good time, and I don't want to live in the past. Mm-hmm. The past was great, and it was the old, it's history. Mm-hmm. Now is the future is mystery, you know? Mm-hmm. And now is the present. And that's what they call it, the present. It's like every day, it's a gift, it's a present, okay? But I like living, I like traveling, I like meeting people, I like meeting East Labs, and I like meeting the whole world. It's where I come from, it's home. Mm-hmm. It's what I know best. So I was working in business, the corporate world, in business, wearing a suit and tie every day. And I, for about 15 years, mm-hmm. I said, bodybuilding no more. Mm-hmm. It's mm-hmm. the past. Mm-hmm. And it was nice, but it's the past. But then certain things happened. I met Cutler Jim and Adam and Kathy Bella, who owner of Cutler Jim. And I came to a seminar after 20 years of doing those seminars. Mm-hmm. I came to the gym in Gyor. Mm-hmm. Hundreds and hundreds of people. I'm like, oh, my mm-hmm. God. Mm-hmm. And I realized, and I told my CEO back home, I said, I have the opportunity to travel again. And I have to leave for a month at a time. Mm-hmm. And he goes, Tom, if you don't take this opportunity to do what you do best and to do what you're supposed to do in life, I'm going to fire you. He was joking. Okay, wow. But he says, whatever you decide, I support you totally. His name is Dino.
That's nice.
But he taught me a lot about business. You know something, though? It's the same as the gym. Mm-hmm. In the gym, you train hard, mm-hmm. you fall down, you get up, you fail, you win. Mm-hmm. The same in business. The same. The gym was perfect training for business. Mm-hmm. But now I say, I come back to the business I know best.
Thank you.
And it's good to be here.
Skrátka, opäť som sa pýtal, že v strednom veku, ako cíti sa ako kulturista v strednom veku, postupne povedal, že je to úžasné, že by nechcel mať 20 rokov, že každý deň sa zobudí, teší sa na každý deň, minulosť je minulosť, teším sa na budúcnosť, lebo minulosť poznáme, budúcnosť nepoznáme. A vlastne 15 rokov chodil v obleku, pracoval v biznise a potom snažil sa zabudnúť na kulturistiku a stále niečo mu tam stále niečo vedel, že jedno na to príde a vlastne po seminári v Győri v Cutter's Gym zistil, že vlastne toto je jeho poslanie a vlastne so šéfom si sa dohodol tak, že teda ide do toho, že keď pokiaľ nebude on robiť to, čo je vlastne on sám sebou, tak polosrandy hovorí, že ho vyhodí ten šéf, hej. Ale zase sa naučil, že biznis je tiež, má veľa, veľa spoločného s kulturistikou, takže ho to obohatilo a prijíma tie princípy z kulturistiky do biznisu a zase naspäť. I would like to ask you from the golden era, the golden eagle. Zlatý orol bola prezivka Tom Pleca, Placa, ako my všetci vieme. From the old school, which guys do you hook up regularly? Everybody would like to know, do you work out with Arnold? Trénuješ s Arnoldom a s ktorými starými borcami zo zlaté éry si udržiavaš kontakt?
I see Arnold every morning at Gold's Gym.
Wow, wouldn't be all. I was there, he wasn't there. I was there for 10 days working out my hands, he wasn't there. Ja som ho bohužiaľ nezažil, keď som tam makal.
Well, it's funny because years ago, he never came to Gold's Gym. And as he became super, super famous, he stayed home in his private gym. And I told friends, I said, tell Arnold to come to the gym. Tell him to come. And he stayed away. So a year ago, I'm in the gym, and I see Arnold on his bicycle. And I'm saying, I go, I don't believe it. I said, welcome back. Welcome back home. You know, and it's great. Everybody's there. I mean, you know, Ferrigno's there, Arnold's there. I mean, celebrities, movie stars, and everybody is fine. Nobody, it's no problems. And it's not always nice to go home. But for me, my home is not only in Gold's Gym mm-hmm. in California. Many people want to stay home. They want to stay home and stay in Gold's. I always wanted to travel and go to all the countries. Because when Arnold retired, from bodybuilding, when I was his student.
1980.
My mentor.
1980.
Yeah. He said, I'm retiring.
After Australia.
Yes, I'm going into movies.
The Conan and all this stuff. Yeah.
And he did the intro to my book. He said, now it's your turn. He says, mm-hmm. run with it. Run with the ball. Go ahead. I'm going to movies. So I'm like, nobody else wanted to do it. But I wanted to travel. There was no Facebook, no Instagram, so you had to go to countries. You had to travel around the world. And I, people always said to me, if you wanted to win the Olympia so bad, why didn't you stay home more and train? Mm-hmm. Nah, I wanted to go out and see people and talk to people about the sport of bodybuilding. It's important to me. Sometimes I feel like a preacher. I feel like a religious priest. But it is, bodybuilding is my religion. Seriously, but I enjoy very much bodybuilding, but I enjoy giving back. And it's not about me getting there anymore. It's about me noticing other champions and going and giving them the energy.
Duly appreciated. This is amazing. Chcem vrátiť späť k turistike a mám stále tú energiu. A keď som sa vrátil do Mekky, do Ghost Gym, zrazu jedno dňa Arnold prišiel na bicykli a postupne všetky staré mená a vlastne sme sa začali stretávať a stalo sa to, ak sme sa cítili ako doma. A druhá vec, ja mám rád aj cestovať inde, stretávať iných ľudí, cestujem po svete a rád odozdávam ďalej svoje skúsenosti a vyhľadávam nových čampiónov a nové tváre a pozerám sa do budúcnosti.
When you came here to this Chambal gym, Marian Chambal, a Slovak bodybuilding pro, professional, very successful, very good guy, my friend. When you came to his gym, what was your first impression?
I was shocked.
Bol som šokovaný, keď som prvýkrát vstúpil do Chambal gymu.
It looks like he went to Gold's gym and made it just like only
wow,
made it better.
Though. Wow, he's gonna be very happy to hear that, I'm sure. Vyzerá to, ako keby vstúpil, cítil som sa, ako keby som vstúpil do Gold's gymu v Kalifornii, ale to urobil ešte oveľa lepšie, že som bol šokovaný. Bol som šokovaný, hovorím, veľmi rád mu to poviem, že bude sa veľmi tešiť, Maroško.
So now you are here, so the circle, so kruh sa uzavrel, you are here and the circle is closed.
I think your career chooses you.
Myslím si, že vaša kariéra si vás vyberá.
Yeah, I didn't choose body.
Ja som si nevybral kulturistiku.
But I had no choice.
Ale nemal som na výber.
I'm going to give you a little idea. When I was 11, 12, 13, you know, all of us bodybuilders came to California. We all went to California with no money. We left our families for only one reason: to train in the same gym. That was the only reason. We wanted to train in the same gym together and go to the beach together and live life like that.
Keď som bol tínedžer, tak všetci vlastne chalani v mojom veku mali jediný cieľ, nič ich nezaujímalo, bez peňazí, bez ničoho, len prísť do Kalifornie a spolu tam cvičiť v Gold's Gyme a byť úspešný v kulturistike.
But there were Gold's Gym, the very first Gold's Gym, there was 15 people. 10 guys and 5 girls. That was the whole, that was fitness.
That's a funny ratio.
Yeah, it was better that way. But it's grown a lot, and I was growing a lot since then. Yeah. But when the very first Gold's Gym, they asked, I'm 1979, I made $40,000. I'm like, wow, I'm rich. Mm-hmm. And
at the time it was different.
At the time, 1979, $40,000. I'm like, so they said, we're gonna give you half a Gold's Gym for $20,000. And I said, no, I buy a Corvette instead. Big mistake.
V 79. som zarobil $40,000 a za $20,000 mi ponúkali polovičný podiel v Gold's Gyme. Som povedal, že no to ani ne, radšej som si kúpil Corvettu. A tak dodnes sa spýtujem. Prosím. Takže dodnes som mal vlastne že blondiavú priateľku, super auto a tešil som sa zo života. Takže
20 years later.
A o 20 rokov neskôr.
20 years later, I was doing very well in bodybuilding. And my neighbor said, "Tom, I want you to invest in my company."
Sa mi veľmi darilo v kulturistike, sused ma poprosil, aby som investoval do jeho firmy.
He said to me, "I have an idea for a coffee shop."
Povedal, že mám taký špeciálny nápad na sieť kaviár.
I said, "You can buy coffee anywhere. There's thousands of coffee shops in Europe." And I said, "No, I'm not going to invest."
Do toho nebudem investovať, však máš plno kaviarní všade na svete, milióny kaviarní, do toho nebudem.
Do you know what he called his coffee shop?
I think
Starbucks.
Na deca Hollywood story. A čo, viete, ako sa volala jeho sieť? Starbucks.
A billionaire.
So I have no business.
Takže nemám business.
You are the business.
Yeah.
Tom Plec, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Bratislava, Slovakia, thank you. Tom Plec,
thank you.
Ďakujem pekne, pozdravujeme East Labs. Tešíme sa, Tom Plec je s nami. Pekný deň ešte, všetko dobre, majte sa krásne.
Okay, bye-bye. All right.